If you use Word, you must use sections. You can control the layout at will. You can make any page landscape. You can have different headers, footers for different types of pages. You can have a single column text and multiple column text on the same page. You can even say the first page is special. It should use glossy paper and remaining pages regular paper. Basically, anything related to page layout, headers, footers, numbering, you have complete control over once you learn sections. So let's get started. So we think document contains pages, pages contain sentences. That is correct. But there is something above pages. When you create a new document, it creates a section first. First section, section one. And in the section, it adds pages. Pages cannot be on their own. They have to be a part of a section. Which basically means all our documents have just one section. Whenever you want to change something at page layout level, or for headers, footers, for columns, that cannot be changed at page level. It can be changed only at section level. So if you go to the layout menu, you'll see so many settings here. None of these settings can be changed at page level, although it is called page setup. This one opens the proper page setup dialog. And here you can see that everything which is written here applies to the whole document. Why is it applying to the whole document? Because we have only one section. Now, by default, you don't see section, but here in the status bar, I am able to see section. By default, section is off. So right click on the status bar, enable sections, and now lifelong you will see it. So how do you add a section? Let's see that first. What are we supposed to do? Add some kind of break. Why is it called break? Because we say page break, isn't it? So if you go to layout, you will see page break. You click here, a new page starts. Now this is the first page. Now if I go to the second page, it is still section one. If I go to the last page, it is still section one. Now I want to add a new page and also have a new section. Well, I go to breaks and then I say section break. Page break means what? New page. Section break means what? New section. But in addition to new section, I want another page as well. So this is new page. So it is page two, but it is also section two now. So that's how you add a section break along with a page break. I need not add a section and also add a page. Sometimes I just want to add a new section, but I want to continue on the same page. So notice this is section two, this is section two. Now I want to add a new section here so that this is section two, this should be section three. How do I do that? So again, I go to breaks. I do want a new section, means I want a section break, but I don't want another page. So new section, same page. That means the page continues. That's why it's called continuous. Now nothing seems to have changed really here, but you will see this is section three and this is section two. So that's how you add a continuous page break. And there are others like even page or odd page. Typically, this is for writing books. So when you want to add or start a new chapter, we don't want to start it on the left side page. We always want to start in the right side odd numbered page. So now if I go to page setup, you will notice this apply to, which was earlier only saying whole document. Now it is saying this section because there is more than one section. Just to make this easier to understand, I'm going to change the top margin to 5 centimeters. And now it will say only this section. Now if I go and look at multiple pages, notice the margin has changed only for this section, not for other sections. To make this even easier to understand, I'm going to go to the header and I'm going to put the section number. How do I do that? I have to insert a field, parts, and then say field. And there is a field called section. Now you can see how this works. So have a look at the upcoming videos and you will master use of sections in Word. So that's it for now. Thank you.